Today, on the Australian Photography Show, we're going to Death Row with Rob Miller to learn why backgrounds are the key to making portraits really stand out. Today, we're going to talk all about portrait photography. And the first rule is, find the best background you can. And that's why I've brought Nicole to Death Row. Today, we're going to meet Rob Miller from Image Tree. And Rob's not only an expert at portrait photography, he teaches hundreds of people every year how to take photos of their friends and family as portraits. And Rob, you've picked a sensational backdrop here.
It's fabulous, isn't it, Steve? It lends itself to a myriad of different backgrounds, and the backgrounds to me are the most important part of a photograph.
So you start with the background and work your way forward.
Yep, we see the background as a set and we see the subject as a placement in the set.
Oh.
In fact, I've got a bit of a saying. The subject is the most important part of the photograph, but the background's more important.
Well, let's go and see what background you've got chosen for Nicole through this way.
Good, good.
Oh, I feel like Johnny Cash.
And again. That's fine, that's around about F8. We'll take this to about F16.
So, Rob, while you're in the mode of setting up this, tell me about what you're doing here with the light meter. Why is that so important?
Okay, we're setting the light on the background first of all, Steve. That's what's important, to get this thing looking good. Then our model will be about here. So that's her background, that's lit. There's also a slight spill coming across which will cut a little bit of an edge around her. And this is the light that's going to light the top part of her. Now I may pull it down a little bit tighter than a softbox, so I may put an umbrella in there but collapse it. Okay, because I'm after her face, her head, her chest, and not much else.
Okay, so you're going to focus on a certain area and almost fine-tune the lights onto that area as she comes in.
That's right, yeah.
So why this? Is it the contrast?
It is to a degree, but one of the things that we see like an egg, we don't see in a box. Okay, so you'll notice that this is quite bright in here and this is quite dark.
Yeah.
So we get that sort of vignetting effect, which you'd use in your movies as well.
Of course.
And that vignetting darkens the edges or can even blur the edges and then pull you into the middle.
Focuses your attention
on her.
On the subject,
yeah. And the background becomes a support.
Rob, when you were setting all that gear up, all that gear ended up being only two lights. I was expecting banks of lights and a rack on the top and lots of helpers, but you've only got two. So starting with this one, what do the two do?
Okay, this is our background light. It's gridded. We want it very tight on the background.
And the honeycomb actually helps you create a focus, like a focus beam of light?
It does, but it also blends outwards to darkness, which gives us our vignetting effect.
So an actual created vignette, rather than using Photoshop, you're going to start with the background and create your own vignette there.
Exactly, exactly.
And that's your modelling light that's on at the moment?
At the moment, yep.
Allowing us to set our framing and then boom, this will be a flash when we're
ready
to go.
That's right, yeah. We just need to know where it is at the moment, so when you're actually looking through the model to the background,
yep,
you can actually see where the light is.
So this won't hit the model, this will just hit the background?
It'll hit the background.
Wow, okay, so let's go and look at this one.
Okay.
If that is the background flash, this must be the model's flash.
That's right.
And that's a softbox.
It is.
Now, do you always use a softbox for modelling?
Not always. I prefer to use as hard a light as possible, but because of the nature of this girl, I just want to soften the light a little bit. You'll notice it's only a small softbox.
Yeah, really small.
It's not a
big one. Yeah.
Because I just want to light her head, her chest, and maybe down to her thighs, and that's it.
So focus on the features of interest.
That's it.
Take this back now to someone that's got a camera, their parents are over from overseas, and they want to light them in the same way. How do you do it quickly?
Okay, shutter speed looks after the background, okay? And the background is a camera thing. In other words, the camera's got to be set up to take the picture.
Right.
For the background.
So light the background first.
Yes.
Find a light place for them to stand.
Or even an exposure. An exposure that suits the background.
Yep.
And then the pop-up flash will fill the person to the background.
That's your built-in flash.
Yep.
And that light there is the light that's in the surrounding areas.
That's right.
Wow. All right. So we're ready for the model now. Let's wheel her in. Well, actually, we've got to go find her. The ghost might have got her.
Maybe.
There's plenty of ghosts around here, I'm told. Rob, we're almost ready, and we better hurry because I can actually hear people over there, and I'm not lying, I know them. They're hunting for ghosts. So before they all come this way, why don't we get going? First of all, you're gonna shoot the background, yeah? Make sure you like it. Great, it's bright enough.
I'm happy with that.
And now we're ready for Nicole. I'm sure everyone is. They're sick of looking at us. Hello.
Hi,
first of all, a couple of meters between the background and the model. Is that what you're aiming for?
Yep, because there's no shadows cast by this light of her on the background.
Very good.
In fact, if you look at the shadow, it's actually falling over here, which is outside the line that I'm shooting in. And what we do with the model, we work to her strengths. So, beautiful face, lovely hair. Okay, I want her side on to me, okay? Because that narrows her, but no woman likes their shoulders narrowed. So now we just bring the shoulder around this way like this. And the hands are just hanging, so we don't like that. So we'll just get her to hold the edges of the jacket, okay? Now we've just got to make sure there's no hair blowing across her face. Okay. I'll just get her to turn through center, so she turns her head that way a little bit. Now she brings her eyes back to me. Just bring your face back a little bit this way. That's good. Excellent. Okay. Now normally I get them to think about something. So if I want a serious look, I just frame her up and I just say to her, think of the last pet that you had that died.
Oh, really?
And I get that sort of look in the eyes, okay?
So as you see Snowball go through the tire tread, that's the shot
you want. That's the shot I want. Okay?
Oh, great.
And then this might work or it might not work. I'll ask her to think of the last really nice present that her boyfriend bought her. Okay.
So you're trying to distract her really away from the fact that she's looking at a camera.
Yeah, because it's quite confronting to have this thing looking at you. So now we'll just try tilting the head a little bit. No, bring your head up a little bit straighter, chin down a little bit.
Beautiful. You're creating angles there. That's what you're doing, aren't you?
Okay. Now just look at me with those eyes. Good. And again on three. One, two, three. One, two, three. The reason why we count to three is because we don't want the light causing her blinking.
So give people warning that the photo's coming.
That's right. That's right.
This is nice, mate. What's this? Oh, it's a Canon?
It's a Canon, yeah.
Oh, it's an EOS 20D. Yeah. Yeah. So let's say I wanted to get a bit crazy with crazy angles. Do you recommend that?
Okay, but first of all, before you do that, check where your background light is.
Okay, my background light is in front of her.
Okay, so if you go to your left, it'll now be right behind her.
So you'll want it right behind her?
Possibly. It's up to you. It's your shot.
I want her to look down on me. So is this autofocus at the moment?
Yep, just on the eyes, centre on the eyes of
the
reframe.
Three, two, one, dead cat.
Okay, now she's a little bit lost there. Give us something to think about.
Well, I gave a dead cat. What more can I do? All right. Think of you've just jumped off the Empire State Building and ops, you've forgotten your parachute. Three, two, one. Oh, I like that. That works.
Excellent.
That really works.
Now, would you like to do something a little bit interesting? Just stay like that.
What's more interesting than off the building with no parachute?
Bring your feet together. Okay. Now, on three, she'll do a little jump in the air.
Oh, so, jump in the air. Okay,
so
I like it.
Just make sure there's enough space for her to jump into. Ready? So bend your knees slightly.
At the top.
And then on three.
Three, two, one.
Not too high. Just a little one. No, sweet.
Actually, that's all right. This is really good.
Just a little one. Just a little one.
Three, two, one. Right. The camera didn't go off.
Okay.
Three, two, one. Oh, see? It's all in the timing.
It is the timing. Open
three,
the shoulders, sweet.
Two, one. Lovely.
Okay.
Like it.
The hair goes up slightly.
It does.
Yeah. Just gives it a little bit of buoyancy.
I prefer that to dead cat.
Do you?
So, Rob, if this was the 1950s and we were bad boys, we'd be having our dinner here right now, I'm afraid. I don't fancy that much. But it is an awesome place for photography and using two lights, such a simple way to go. If you're going to sum up portrait photography, though, in just one sentence to make everyone a better portrait photographer, what would it be?
The old favourite, Steve. Keep it simple, stupid.
Don't call me stupid. Of course, it's easy for him to say, put your arm there, hold this, turn your head that way. But if someone just thrusts a camera in your face, what's a good tip for people to make sure they don't come off looking like Shrek?
Don't say cheese and over smile.
Don't say cheese.
You get a really big grin and you look quite funny. Try not to blink, so try and keep your eyes open. And
should you ask him for a countdown?
I like to, yeah. Just go like, give me a second and so I can get refresh myself and things like that. So you're not just going, oh gosh, like, okay.
Yeah. Of course, there's always going to be the friend that takes great pleasure in making sure you look as bad as possible.
Yeah, you always get one. You'll always have one or two bad pictures, so.
Yeah, you can't even think about that. One or two. That's pretty much every picture of me ever taken. But that's why I'm not a model.
On the next episode, we're going to meet a Getty photographer who'll talk about a career in sports and action photography while showing you how to turn your kids into stars when you shoot them on the sporting field. See you then.
I've seen empires rise then fall out of the sky. I've watched history unfold like the iron butterfly. I've danced through life with diamonds on my feet. A long road that runs right to my destiny.